There's a lot of debate within the whole food plant-based community on whether or not it's safe to consume soy. This is because a study found that just 40 grams of soy protein added to our diet can significantly increase levels of a powerful cancer-promoting growth hormone, IGF-1. This growth promoter has been strongly linked to the development of cancer of the breast, prostate, lung, and colon. Excess IGF-1 stimulates cell proliferation and inhibits cell death, two activities you definitely don't want when cancer cells are involved. But what does 40 grams equal? Well, one soy chicken patty and two soy burgers add up to that 40 grams. Let's hear Dr. Caldwell Esselstyn's answer to the question, is soy safe to consume?
Again, now we're talking about soy. I eat soy. I eat soy maybe, or tofu, maybe 3-4 times a month, but my wife makes a wonderful dessert with it. But I'm a little cautious about soy once it has been highly processed. I think edamame is fine, but even there, it's 40% fat. And my good friend Colin Campbell, who wrote the China study, has pretty well convinced me that an excess of soy protein can increase your IGF-1, which is a tumor promoter.
Dr. T. Colin Campbell states, soybeans in their whole form, in soups or as edamame, are fine occasionally, but I'd not recommend anyone drink glasses of soy milk, especially kids. Dr. John McDougall has said this about soy. There is a dark side to the soy story that warns that these foods may increase your risk for cancer, impair your thyroid, immune and brain function, and cause you bone loss and reproductive problems. Fortunately, these worries are relevant mostly for people lured into consuming fake foods synthesized from man-made components of soy and other foods, and high-potency soy supplements, not for those who consume traditional soy foods as a small portion of their diet. So it looks like there are two issues here. The first is that soy products may not be healthy when consumed in large amounts, and secondly, that heavily processed soy and isolated soy protein products may behave very differently in the body when compared to whole soy foods like edamame beans or even tofu. So now let's hear from Dr. Michael Greger as he shares from the research how many servings of soy, if any, are safe for us to eat.
So is there some magic number of soy food servings we should shoot for? So far, we know that somewhere between 7 and 18 may not be so good, so more than 18 definitely gets the axe. This two-year study found no effect on IGF levels of adding two servings of soy food daily, whether they were tofu, soy milk, soy nuts, or the concentrated soy isolate found in plant-based meats, protein bars, or protein powder, still fine. Still got a big range here. This study suggested 5 to 10 servings a day was bad, increased IGF. So we're kind of slowly but surely narrowing down the kind of safety window. Same year in Japan, 3 servings a day cleared the IGF radar. And then that's it. That's all the science we have so far. The bottom line is legumes should be part of everyone's daily diet, which means lentils, peas, and or beans, ideally with each of our meals, of which soy is an excellent choice, but I recommend that we should probably stick to no more than 3 to 5 servings a day.
Thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up, leave a comment below, and subscribe for more upcoming videos.